know more such amazing stories from Indian history, click the bell icon and subscribe to Live History India.
Gujarat is a land with music at the very heart of its culture. From the stark yet stunning deserts of Kutch to the verdant hills of Chota Udaipur, and finally the mysterious forests of Dang and Bapi. The story of Gujarat's musical instruments cannot be told. It can only be heard, as it is older than language itself. We start our journey in Kutch. Famous for its white sands, it is as though the vibrant sounds and vivid colours make up for the desolate landscape here. Kutch is a land that opened its arms to migrant communities from Sindh, Rajasthan and even Persia. The musical instruments found here reflect this unique confluence. Take for instance the colourful sarangi. Usman Jat is the only musician who still plays it. Originally from Sindh, Usman explains how the sarangi is an intrinsic part of his cattle herding community known as Maldharis.
मेरा पिताजी का जो पिताजी था दादा वो मेरे पिताजी को सिखाया कि भाई ये चीज सीखने लायक है और रखने के भी लायक है बहुत पुरानी चीज मिलेगा नहीं बाद में इसको बोलते हैं पसंद करते हैं सुरदो इसमें छह तार पांच तार आते हैं पांच भी आते हैं छह भी आते हैं इसमें एक पीतल का तार होता है वो पीतल का नहीं होगा तो बजेगा नहीं सुर भी नहीं पकड़ेगा और उसके बकरी का चमड़ी भी होना चाहिए और इसका गज जो होता है उसका घोड़े का बाल भी होना चाहिए ये सब साथ में रहेगा तब बजेगा
Usman, a truck driver by day, says he doesn't get to play the sarangi as often as he would like. But he is keen to pass on this legacy to his son, along with his 150-year-old sarangi crafted by his ancestors. Noor Muhammad is another musician who has played a crucial role in reviving the fortunes of an instrument unique to Kutch, the Jodia pava, an unusual double flute. He has helped make the instrument go global through performances across the world and has even worked with A.R. Rahman in the film Rockstar.
हमारी संस्कृति है लोकवादी है जो मैं बजा रहा हूँ इसको कम से कम 30 साल हुआ है हम लोग तो बाहर से आए हैं लेकिन तो इसको बहुत पुरानी बात है ये 150-300 साल हो गया है उधर हमारे दादा पापा भी ये वारसागत बजाते थे इधर इंडिया में आके लुप्त हो गया था उनके बाद मैंने सीखा सुना ये जो अलगोजा है जोड़िया पावा ये स्टार्टिंग मालदारी जो बहुत बजाते और गायें भैंसा बकरा जो गेटा चराने जाते जंगल में तो ये वाद्य है तो ये बहुत इस्तेमाल करते हैं और बड़ा वाला को नर बोलते हैं कंटूनी सुर इसमें बजते हैं उनको नर बोलते हैं मेल फीमेल बोलते हैं ना वो नर है लेकिन ये फीमेल है जो ये मादा बोलते हैं छोटा वाला मादा है तो इसमें सुर सुरावली राग रागनी सब मादा में छोटे वाले में बजती है वो बड़ा वाला नर है उसमें कंटूनी सुन का सुर रह रहा है
Thanks to the efforts made by him and local organizations supporting traditional musicians, today students from across the world are coming to Kutch to learn the Jodia Pava, thus ensuring it stays alive. Another wind instrument from the Kutch region is the Morchang. Like the sarangi, it too traveled to Kutch with migrant communities from Sindh. Interestingly, strains of this instrument can be heard across Central Asia and the Middle East. It may have traveled the world, but this humble instrument is rooted to this landscape and serves some very practical purposes. It is said that cattle recognize the unique sound of their herder's morchang and thus find their way back home. Interestingly, we find an early version of the sitar, the santar, too here, a simple stringed instrument associated with the wandering minstrels who once walked these roads. One of the popular percussion instruments of Kutch is the dakla or dak. Local Maldhari pastoralists play the dakla in temples. It is also believed that the sound of the dak keeps off the evil eye. From Kutch, we move east to Sabarkantha, a region famous for its beautiful arts and crafts. It's not surprising to find an instrument here that is as lovingly crafted as it is played, the Ravanhata, also known as sarangi. For the musicians, the Ravanhata isn't a source of livelihood, but a priceless inheritance towards which they feel a sense of responsibility.
આ રાવણહથ્થો અમે તો ઘરે બનાવીએ તો જ એનું તાલ રાગ મિલાવટ થાય. જ્યારે બનાવટી દુકાનમાંથી ખરીદીએ તો એનું તાલ મર્યાદા સચવાય નહીં. શિવરાત્રિમાં તો દરેક જગ્યાએ અમને રાવણહથ્થો જ બોલાવે છે, કેમ કે શિવનું બનાવેલું છે રાવણહથ્થો. એટલે એ ભજનોમાં મોજ આવે એટલે શિવનું બનાવેલું છે, રાવણે બનાવેલો. એટલે આ રાવણહથ્થો શિવરાત્રિના દિવસ તો સારા ગુજરાતમાં રાવણહથ્થાનું બહુ માન છે.
Just as the landscapes keep changing as you travel through this beautiful state, the instruments too display this variety. In the rich and lush districts of Dang and Tapi in southern Gujarat reside tribal communities who are probably the earliest settlers of this ancient land. Their instruments reflect their surroundings.
Adivasi sangeet jo che char prakar na vadya che ema ek vadya che te phukni vadya je phukine vagadvanu che ne vaktu hoy એવું વાદ્ય છે ફૂંકણી વાદ્યો. બીજું વાદ્ય છે તે ડફલી વાદ્યો, એટલે જે એક જ તરફનું વાગતું હોય તે થાળી હોય કે મંજીરા હોય, ખંજીરા હોય, કરતાલ હોય, એ બધા છે તે બીજા પ્રકારનું વાદ્યો. ત્રીજા પ્રકારનું જે વાદ્ય જે છે એ ઢોલ વાદ્યો, તે બે તરફનું વાગતું હોય અને બંને તરફ ફક્ત મોટો ઢોલ હોય, એ બધા એ ત્રીજા પ્રકારનું વાદ્યો. અને ચોથા પ્રકારનું વાદ્ય જે છે એ વાદ્ય છે તંતુ વાદ્યો, જે ગાંગલી હોય કે તંબુરું હોય, એ જે બધા હોય એ તંતુ વાદ્ય કહેવાય. તેમ ચૌધરી સમાજનું જે ડોવડું છે એ ડોવડું ફૂંકણી વાદ્ય તરીકે ઓળખાય છે. મોટું વાદ્ય વાગતું હોય તેમ ડોવડું કહેવામાં આવે.
This colourful and intriguing looking instrument is the dobru. Made out of bottle gourd and beautifully decorated, the instrument is an integral part of the region's festivals and celebrations. While the dobru is intrinsic to the Chaudhary community, the fascinating tur belongs to the Jodia community and is one of the most unique instruments in the country, which can be played in 56 different ways. The tur is accompanied by another instrument known as the thali.
Jodia samaj vishe apne vato karvana chhe to Jodia samaj chhe e samare rite akhar ta dhule thi avela ધોળિયા તરફથી આવેલા એમ એ લોકોનો ઇતિહાસ એવો પણ છે. તુર એ સમાજે સ્વીકારેલું અને 9 લાખ જેટલી એ લોકોની વસ્તી પણ છે. એ લોકોએ સ્વીકારેલું તુર સ્વીકારેલું છે. તુર અને થાળી એટલે એ એક છે તે પહેલાં ડફલી વાદ્ય કહી શકાય અને એક છે તે જે બંને બાજુનું વાગતું ઢોલ વાદ્ય કહી શકાય. એવો તુર વાગતું હોય તો તુર જેવો છે એ સામાન્ય રીતે કાદવના કાંઠો બનાવેલો હોય, એનું કાંઠો આવે છે, કાદવનો બનેલો હોય, માટી હોય, માટીનો કાદવ બનાવેલો હોય અને કાદવ બનાવીને પછી એક બનાવેલું હોય. તુર જે વાગે 56 ચાળા તુરમાં કડાવે છે.
Another region of Gujarat with a rich musical tradition is Chota Udaipur, home to several tribal communities. Institutes like the Adivasi Academy are today cataloging and helping revive the many quaint musical instruments of this region.
Tarathwa community mein khas taur se pehi musical instruments ne inke jo khet hote hain makka ke khet ke beech mein inhone ek lakdi ka mala banate hain aur wo mala pe baith ke wo pehi musical instruments bajate hain.
One of the most interesting instruments here is the mota piha, a big flute which is played by a group of musicians who also dance as they play. The instruments of Gujarat are diverse and unique, but they all have one thing in common: their connection to the land and their role in keeping communities together. This is why it is crucial to keep these traditions alive, for they are the roots nourishing this beautiful and vibrant state.